Hey guys, welcome back to another very exciting tutorial of Creatnprocess and today's video we'll be designing this logo. Let's look at this logo. In this logo we have got two shapes, each of them identical to each other, and they have been attached like a chain like molecular structure. And you can also see that we have got a nice shiny effect over it and the text. So to design this logo we'll follow only four steps. First, we'll create the basic structure of this logo. Second, we'll create that chain-like structure. Third, we'll add the grading color, fill it with the colors. And fourth and finally, we'll add the reflections and the text. So let's begin with the tutorial. So to start with the tutorial, we'll select the ellipse tool and left click your mouse button. In width and height, fill it up with 50 by 50. And click the OK button. You can see we have got a nice small circle here. So we will remove the fill color and fill the stroke color. Now the next thing is we will use a line segment tool and left click your mouse button, and here take a length of 50 points and the angle 0 and click OK. Click one more time, keep the length 50 and angle 120. Click one more time, click the keep the length same and the angle to be 240 degree. Now we'll place all these small line segments together. So we'll keep this here and here. Make sure all these points coincide each other. The points like this. Once you have done that, group this up, Control G, and place it in the center of the circle here. Now click the circle with the Alt press, duplicate this and bring this out and keep it here. Like endpoints of the line segment should be the center of the circle, new circle. In the same way, duplicate one more time and place it like this. Again, bring it one more time and place here like this. Once we have done this, we'll do one more step. We will select the ellipse tool again and left click your mouse button, and now this time we'll keep the width and height around double. That's earlier we have used 50, now it's 100. So we have to double the width and height and click the OK button. And now bring this and just keep it here in such a way that the two sides of this small two circles touches the edge of this big circle. So just make sure that, just zoom it in and place it there properly like this. It should intersect a little bit. If this is going too large, then just push it out and make sure it happens here also. There should be intersection. If it's not, you should just make it intersect. Zoom it in and just make sure it's intersection. Or duplicate one more time. Select this big circle and duplicate one more time, and now this time we'll place this here. The same way, it should intersect this edge of the circle. So make sure, just zoom it in, select, okay, this side is okay. Make sure this side is also okay. Little bit more, and this is fine. Now duplicate this one more time. Here, bring it here, place it properly in such a way that the edges of the circle intersect each other a little bit like this. Zoom it in, make sure it should not be large, just the intersection portion. The same way, make sure here also it got intersected, it's very huge, then just pull it out. Okay, this side little bit inner inside, we should need to put this inside more, and let's find out. Now once we have done all this stuff, select everything and select the shape builder tool. Now make sure you can see that, yeah, it's intersected, it's fine, everything is going fine. Now the next step is to fill this to combine this one, we'll combine these pieces, these, it should be combining, we have to be combining only these outer portions, and this will be separate, this separate. After we have done that, we'll delete this, and we can even just drag it this out and delete everything else. So we got a nice shape, we got the nice basic structure of this design. Once we have done that, we can see in the corners we have some sharp edges, you can see that. To remove that, we'll go to Object, Path, Simplify, and here just preview it. And this, in the curve precision, we'll keep around 96 and keep this 0. And so if we preview it, you can see the edges here, it was pointed. If we preview it with this option, it has smoothed all the corners, and click the OK. And if you see here something is wrong, you can just go in there, see what's the problem. Okay, this one, just make sure it's aligned, and that's all, we have done it. Now the next thing to do is we'll fill it with some basic color so that we can okay, before that I'll just make sure it's like this. Now fill this with some basic color, I'll pick this color and duplicate this one more time, Control C, Control F, and just bring it in the front, drag it down a little bit, and that's all. And the lower one, I'll just change its color to a little bit darker so that we can differentiate that. Once we've done that, we'll duplicate this once, Control C, Control F, and just change the angles like this, and just make sure it's here, we'll place it properly with the arrow keys like this, and let's change its color to something else like orange, and the lower one with darker orange. We can change this color like this. This one we have already chosen that. So we'll select this color and make sure and just play with the reflection. This one, we need to move this a little bit right side and downward like this. Okay. And we can just scale this up a little bit so that we can do the perfections here. Make sure. Okay. You can see that we have got the basic shape, basic curves and all. We can just play with the reflections here. We can just make it thinner. And a little bit right side, left side. Okay. The same way we'll do for the orange one, just push it up a little bit more. Yeah, fine. So we can see there is a reflection, there is inner reflection, that's what we need. Now the next step is we'll select everything, and with the shape builder tool again, we'll do some adjustment here. We'll select, fill this with same color, just drag and select that portion to combine. Just click and drag and everything will be combined. We need this to be combined. You can see we need this portion to be on the top, so just select and combine it. This one we need to be combined, and this one also, it should be on the top, so we'll select and just combine it. This one should be on the top, this should be combined, I think. Yeah, this one is fine, this one is separate, I think. This should be separate, this should be separate, and this one also should be separate. And here we need some tutoring to do. We'll just combine these small pieces, and that's all. Now the next thing is to select and fill the same color here. And this one, fill it with dark, this one, this one, and this small pieces here fill the same dark color. So you can see we got a nice reflection here, nice perspective view like a chain. Due to this effect, we have used the shape editor to create this. So once we have done that, we'll do some gradient color corrections here. So we select this, and with the gradient tool, just play with that. We need a dark portion here and lighter on the top, so we'll do that. Just play with that. Okay, fine. Once you've done that, now the next thing is this one. We need all these pieces selected at once, and we'll play with the gradient. So this and this. Okay, so with the gradient selected, just drag, and you can even change the color with the eye picker, and with the gradient tool, just move the colors. Okay, that's fine. The darker should be here, and here should be some darker portion also here. So on the top it should be dark, and here light. So you can see that there's a lighter and there's dark, fine. Now the next thing for this here, we're gonna use the same, or we can keep this like this, that's fine. There's one thing here, like this reflection, we need small piece of reflection here, so we'll just use the shape builder and separate this piece out. And now, select this with the gradient tool selected, just adjust it. And you can see it, yep. So once you have done that, we'll add this glossy effect. To create that, we'll just select this and this and duplicate this, Control C, Control F. Now on the top, we'll draw one more big circle here, and we'll keep this a little bit aside and just bring in one and place it properly here like this, maybe this. And select this and go to the pathfinder and subtract it. In the same way, we'll bring in this and place it there, go to pathfinder, select both of them, go to pathfinder and subtract it. Now select this piece and this piece, and with the eye picker we'll select this color, this color is white, and we have reduced the opacity to 30%, so it's looking like that. So once we have created that, the last thing we are left with is text. So we'll write the text AIR, and we'll use the Funk Medium font. So we'll just find that out. It will be somewhere here, or you may just copy this, Control C, and paste it there, selecting this text, Control V. So we got that. We have used the Funk Medium text and we have placed it there. We'll fill it with the same color here, dark one. So you can see that we have completed everything. We have created the basic structure, then we have created that chain like structure using the shape builder tool, and finally we added the gradient color and the glossy effect and then text. So this is how we can create these kinds of logo. Hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up, and if you want more updates on designing, you can press the subscribe button. Thank you.